When you start tasting the recitation of Quran, no music will take its place. You will not need to have a fatwa on whether music is halal or haram. Music will just become irrelevant to you. Because the Quran, the divine melody, divine music, revealed music, Quran, that will just flow in your heart and you will just never want to just whistle a tune again. It'll just take over. You know? And you recite Quran with melody. تَغَنَّوْهُ وَتَدَبَّرُوا فِيهِ And think deeply about Quran. Dive into the meanings of Quran. Pull out the pearls and treasures from the Quran. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ So you can become people of success. This is the words of Rasulullah ﷺ. Called us people of Quran. I pray that we're able to live up to that advice. And I pray that Allah Azza wa Jal makes us witnesses, that makes the Quran a witness in our favor and not a witness against us. I pray that Allah helps our communities grow more and more in their iman through their sustained relationship and a constantly growing relationship with the Quran. I pray that our young generation, through that young generation come an entire army of young students and teachers of this book that will spread the love of this book and the understanding of this book for generations to come. This has to be a responsibility the ummah carries, every family carries. We gotta know our book, guys. Whatever Quran you've memorized, at least study that tafsir. At least request the imam to do tafsir of those surahs that you've already memorized. If you've already memorized the surahs from Juz Amma, just take advantage of our podcasts, free downloads. The only thing it will cost you is your time. At least learn what Allah is saying in those surahs. So when you are standing in salat, you're talking to Allah. Talk to Allah. It changes you. It puts light in your day. It puts light in your life. Our kids need this. We need this. Don't just worry about your children's education. It's not like Allah will ask, how did you put them in Islamic school or not? It's not like we are doing justice to this book ourselves. We're not. We're really not. I pray, honestly, and I didn't want to leave you on a downer. I didn't. But it just pains my heart. It really does. It really pains my heart. Ramadan is around the corner, guys. The month of Quran is around the corner. The month that became sacred because the Quran came in it. What makes Ramadan special is not the fasting, is not the pakorde and samosa. It's not... What makes Ramadan special? Quran came in it. Quran came in it. Hudal linnas. In those ayat Allah says, He sent guidance to all humanity. Quran is the month in which this book should be shared with all humanity. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ There's such beautiful description of the Quran for the month of Ramadan itself. The first thing Allah told us about Ramadan was not fasting. He said, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ He doesn't say, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي تَصُومُونَ فِيهِ Month of Ramadan, you're going to fast in it. No. Month of Ramadan, Quran came in it.